In my last video, I showed you how to build a dustproof enclosure for a CNC router. Today, we will add a DIY CNC control panel to it, which makes life in front of the machine so much easier. So, grab a coffee and buckle up for some machining and soldering. Hello and welcome to my channel. As you know, I use Eding CNC to control my hobby machines. And one of its benefits is that it is an open system and you have lots of possibilities for adding all sorts of customized functions. The user interface, however, is not as customizable as I would prefer. You can easily customize the icons and even add a few more on the left side, but basically you are stuck with their overall arrangement. So, to access certain functions, you need to hop through different levels, and especially the user functions are hidden in two different layers. And that's why I prefer to have an additional control panel where you can call up a function with the push of a button. I already made one for my mineral cast router, and it is such an improvement that I definitely need to have one on my new machine as well. The panel is made out of a 9mm thick POM plate. I first prepared a vacuum table by opening the section areas. Then I add a vacuum card and align the workpiece to the table. This kind of vacuum table only works with such a paper card in between the table and the workpiece. It evenly distributes the vacuum, keeps the vacuum despite cut-throughs, and you can mill like 0.5mm below the workpiece without cutting into your valuable table. Once the vacuum is on, the workpiece zero is set using a wireless touch probe and customized probing function. The front side is milled with the outer contour, a chamfer, and an engraving for the feed override function. Despite the soft material, I used an extremely conservative approach with a very small step over. I often do this when I have rounded edges and I'm too lazy to program an adaptive pass first and then the second finishing contour. I hope this will have an end when I finally move from Fusion to MasterCam, where you can have both strategies in one go. The backside is done in the same fashion. Alignment to the x-axis first, probing, milling an outer contour recess, and then the holes for the switches. Although there is only a moderate drop of the vacuum because of the numerous 60mm holes, I mill them to an 0.5 millimeter remaining stock first to keep the full vacuum, and only finish them with a smaller end mill and a very light cut at the end of the process. With the plate done, I could start to assemble the switches. I have in total 26 switches for various functions, a potentiometer for the feed override, and of course an e-stop. I use ARPEM AO1 switches mainly because their modularity and their various color options. And they are quite easy to label. But you can basically use any switch you want. The heart of the control panel is a small add-on board from Edding called UIO10. This offers up to 32 additional I/O functions, which can be configured by the software, and I will show later how this is done. It is an independent board, which is not connected to the CNC controller, but via a USB connection to the PC, which hosts the control software. You can add switches, selectors, potentiometers, and even MPG encoders to the board, which makes it really versatile and offers lots of different options for an external control panel. In order to make the wiring between the switches and the board a little bit cleaner, I use a pair of twisted wires. You can make them very easily at home with a cordless drill. And then comes the rather tedious task to connect all the switches with the UIO-10. Because I do not have enough depth in the enclosure to connect the wires with crimp-on 2.8mm flap connectors, I have to unfortunately solder them directly to the switches. And although this is almost a therapeutical process, I will shortcut this here to one example. After all the switches are connected comes a task which is even more therapeutical, and that is to label the switches. The benefit for me to have the designation directly on the switch and not engraved or lasered on the panel is that I can easily change a function later on. Besides, I do not have a laser anyway. I use a cheap label maker for this, and in case you're interested in the model, I have a link in the description below. And don't worry, I will again show only one. The entire combo is then placed in the enclosure and held in place with double-sided sticky tape. I have the same principle on my other machine, and it has been working for years without any issues. Here you can see as well that I only have 37mm total depth for the switches, because the whole section will be closed later on with an HDF board to protect everything from dust. The e-stop switch and a few others, which are hardwired to functions like the vacuum pump VFD and the air filtration system, are connected only after the board is in place. After the panel is fixed, the push buttons are added and the hardware part is done. The configuration of the panel is done in the Eding CNC control software. In the settings area is a special section for the UIO-10. Here you can select first if an input is a switch, a potentiometer, a selector or an MPG. But not every input can be selected for everything, and it makes sense to read the manual first. Oh, and by the way, this video is not sponsored by Eding. I have paid everything by myself. Once the inputs are defined, you can assign a function out of a preset menu. They are grouped in sections and are related to the user interface to call certain menus, the so-called user buttons to call a customized feature, homing and zeroing features, lots of stuff for jogging the axis, override functions, output features, and so on. Most of my inputs are related to accessing easily my custom features, like the various probing routines, tool measurements, etc. All these features can be customized with a script in a macro file. This makes Eding very adaptable to your own needs, in contrast to a closed system like Muscle. On the other side, this requires some experience in scripting and coding and is not necessarily a plug-and-play system. Here's a short sequence of the key functions, which I can access now directly with the panel. In the next video, I will complete the enclosure with an integrated air filtration system, so I can safely mill wood without a dust collection. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit the notification bell. Stay tuned and see you next time.